Yes, good morning students. In the previous class, we have discussed certain important concepts like introduction, meaning and definition of the management. Today in this class, we shall know the characteristics of management. Coming to the characteristics of management, management is having their own characteristics. Let us see one by one. First one is management is a goal-oriented process. Obviously, management is a goal-oriented process because management strives or manages to achieve certain final destination or final goal. Let us take an example. We are having the two kings and one king is thinking of defeating another king. It is his final goal or destination. For defeating another king, this king has to manage the weapons which is required to defeat another king, as well as the strategies which is required to defeat another king, and timing, most important timing. ಆ ಕಿಂಗನ್ನು ಯಾವಾಗ ಹೋಗಿ ಅವನ ಮೇಲೆ ದಂಡೆತ್ ಹೋಗಿ ಅವನನ್ನು ಗೆಲ್ಲಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಜೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೈಮಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ನೆಸಸರಿ ದಿ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಡಿಫೀಟ್ ಅಂದರ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಗೋಲ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಗೋಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಡಿಫೀಟ್ ಅಂದರ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಜೀಸ್ Similarly, when it comes to the company, here we are having the two companies like Bata as well as Paragon company. Actually, Bata is making a profit of rupees 50,000 per year, but Paragon is making a profit of rupees 1 lakh rupees. So this Bata company wanted to reach the profit of 1 lakh rupees, which already the Paragon company is already achieving. For this, achieving this final goal, Bata company has to manage his employees in order to make a profit of rupees 1 lakh, and he has to arrange the machineries which is required to make a profit of 1 lakh rupees, and again he has to convince the customers in a best way to purchase the shoes or as well as the slippers of a Bata companies. Thereby he can defeat another companies. So very clear that for defeating any of the company, it requires management. The next second important characteristics of management is management is all pervasive. Pervasive means noticeable in every place or every part. Yes, obviously management is all pervasive. For example, when it comes to the example of sun, obviously you people are might be knowing the sun. I mean Surya. Comes to the sun, it rises in every country. Rises in every country, like we are having certain different countries like India. Even in India it also rises, and even in Australia also it rises, and even in America also it rises. It means the same sun rises in each and every country like India, Australia and America. Similarly, it is very important to note that sun is having the characteristics of a pervasive. Similarly, when it comes to the company or business organization, whatever may be the company, whether it may be kirani stores or whether it may be mall or whether it may be airport. So like this, in each and every business organization, management is required. Whether it may be kirani or whether it may be small or whether it may be big companies, management is required. Every organization has to manage in their own way. The fourth important characteristics of management is a continuous process. Management is not a matter of one day or two day. Till at the each and every day throughout life of a company, management is required. Let's take an example of the company. A company is manufacturing certain footwear business. During summer season, it has effectively managed by supplying the slippers. At the same time, it has to manage the rainy seasons. In the rainy seasons, usually the customers prefer certain shoes to avoid certain rainwater. If you stick on to only the summer season, then it will be failure in the rainy seasons. We may face a loss. Therefore, it has to manage all the seasons like summer, rainy and winter season. Therefore, it is very important to note that management is a continuous process and it is not restricted to a particular day. Then fourth important characteristics of management is management is a group activities. Obviously, management is a group activities and it is not restricted to a single person. All the employees or all the persons who are engaged in the business activities should properly manage the business in order to have the profit. For example, in a company, we are having certain different managers like production manager, sales manager and finance manager. So like this, all the three person has to manage the company in a profit making. Towards profit making, then only it will